Let's see what kind of questions we got today.
We don't got shit, we're just freestyling it.
Come on guys, let's hear some fucking questions. Pick my brain apart.
What color is it?
What?
Your brain.
Purple.
Bruce was born in my house in 1973, and I raised him from a little kid, and I basically took him from his parents, and I brought him up and taught him how to surf and gave him his first board.
Really?
No, that's not true.
Now.
Roll one.
Okay. Bruce, tell us a little about...
I didn't get the mark. Okay, rolling here.
Okay, mark it, Bruce.
Chuck one.
What year were you born?
1979. Are you going to hear your questions in the thing?
I think so.
Okay. I was born in Wilcox Hospital, Kauai.
He was very small when he was born. He was 10 weeks early. He was less than 3.5 pounds.
When he was a kid, he was like 2'5".
He was a little punk. He'd always pick on the bigger guys because he could get away with it.
Cruiser with a sarcastic mouth, but he's a good guy.
Yeah, he definitely gave Andy grief all the time, you know, even though he was quiet.
He was a cocky little guy, there's no doubt about it, but you could tell from an early age that Bruce possessed the gift. When he was really young and he was doing amateur events on Oahu, he must have been like 11 or 12. It was a spring day and the waves were flat at Pipe, but I said, Bruce, get out of my truck, and we walked down to the beach at Pipe, and there was no one around because there was no waves, and we stood on the beach at Pipe, and I said, you see this break right here, bruh? And he was real young, and he goes, yeah. And I go, you own this, and this will be yours one day. Sure enough.
The camera ran out of film.
What do you think inspires Bruce to surf?
I think he just does it because he loves it. But I think the success of his brother definitely inspires him, you know what I mean? I think he might have taken the whole tour lightly until his brother won that first title, and he just went, what the hell, you know what I mean? If he can do it, I can do it, because he used to beat his brother a lot, you know, when they were younger.
Okay, is the WCT everything you imagined it would be? No.
So I thought I was just going to come out, you know, firing, and obviously that didn't happen, but, you know, I got more used to it after the year went on.
He went in there thinking he was probably going to win everything because everyone else was telling him that, and, you know, there's a lot of factors that come into it. The places you go to, I mean, they're usually great waves, but, I mean, it doesn't mean you're going to have good waves in your heat.
A lot of bad heats, me blowing it, waves not that good, canceling events right after heats, and just, you know, just normal stuff that happens to everybody. I just had a lot happen to me, and, you know, did good in two events, and, you know, France was good.
Sitting in the final with my brother, I was just kind of weird. We were both kind of tripping out, just, you know, we weren't really taking it that serious. You know, we were just kind of cruising. I think the scaredness, that's what motivates you to want to go more and more. You know, it's scared feeling, and then you overcome that adrenaline, it just makes you, you know, want to go bigger and get more scared and make it.
Surfing is really, you know, intimidating at times. You know, the waves are big, it's gnarly, you know, and you have a huge wall of water coming and crushing on your head. It's like, it's for real, you know, and you can die doing that, you can drown. You know, I've been skateboarding my whole life, dude. I've never slammed on the ramp and looked up and saw a wall of wood coming down to fall on me.
We'll be right back. WCT?
On the WCT?
Yeah.
Well, the goal is to win the world title. So that's the whole point of being there.
For Bruce to win a world title, it's not going to take a lot. I mean, like, he had a hard year last year, and I mean, like, the tables can turn really easily, and I'm one to say that I don't think it'll take a lot.
I think if anybody's going to give Andy a good shot for the world title, it'll definitely be Bruce.
And I think he's the most dangerous guy on tour.
Bruce needs to modify his whole personality to be accepted on that tour. He's too much of a rebel. You know, people, there's judges out there that are eating dinner, looking across the room going, who the fuck is this guy? You know what I mean?
We serve border. We patent social change. Caressing the pavement.
Dark death,
yeah.
Black cats and zombies.
Why do you wear black t-shirts?
Why do you wear black mascara?
Talk about your relationship with Andy right now.
My relationship with Andy right now is good. You know, we still have our arguments and fight because we're competitive brothers, but you know, it's a lot better. You know, we're both on the tour. He gives me advice.
Do you give Bruce advice on tour?
I don't give Bruce any advice. Oh my God, I saw the biggest wall jumps now. I don't give him fuck of all advice, no. Because he just looks at me and doesn't... Actually, you know what? He kind of listens now. I give him a little bit. I'll try to tell him, you know, before a heat, see what he's doing, just tell him to go surf and not freak out. Because, you know, there's some things I do know. I am the older brother, but, you know, he doesn't see it that way most of the time.
Are you better than him?
Am I better than him? No, I don't think so.
How about free surfing?
No, it's... No. That's a stupid question, too. God, it's such a typical fucking question.
I don't know. He's a lot more fluid and stylish. And I don't know. I don't know how I surf, but he surfs really good. He's really good at positioning himself on the wave and getting himself in the crinkliest part. You know, with barrel riding, I don't think anyone can touch him.
You believe in reincarnation?
I don't know, I think you just float around.
Where do you float?
Everywhere. I don't know, I just picture seeing everything and floating away.
Alright, cool. Barrels or airs?
Barrels.
Can we talk about more of the leaf and the barrel?
Word bingo.
Doesn't matter.
That's okay. Were you ever worried about Bruce requalifying since he didn't do any backup QSs? And he needed a fifth, a pipe to requalify?
Yeah, Bruce needed to qualify at pipe, and no one's going to doubt that. But I was worried, for sure. I mean, I was worried to not have a traveling companion and a good friend, and the sport needed it.
Yeah, him not doing the QSs was pretty stupid, I thought. I mean, as good as he is, the first year on the tour, you do the QS, everyone does. I mean, unless you're in the top five right off the bat.
I was happy not to do the QS, even though I should have, but, you know, whatever happens, happens. It's coming down the pipe.
Do you know a place you need to get to requalify?
No, I didn't look into that. I didn't want to. I'm just going to go out there and just surf. Just surf. Have fun. That was the worst heat of my life.
Like one of the most important,
the most important things I ever had to do, and it was that pipeline going off, and I only got a 1.5. I had that really bad heat at pipe, and I was just like, oh, great. You know, I lost that first heat at a one, and then the eddy was the next day, and
the eddy day, well, waxing our boards 5:30 in the morning, wasn't even really light yet, and Bruce just paddled straight to the pit, you know what I mean? Typical Bruce, like it was pine trees or something. Like a lot of crazy guys were out that morning, and Bruce was paddling deeper than everybody, man.
He was just catching every little wave around, just going off, broke his board. Went in, had to borrow a board. He borrowed McCullough's board, which was broken and put back. It was a broken board, basically, and put back together, and that was the board. He had Lucky Yellow. Yellow ran it.
I caught that wave, I was going all the way in, I was just like, that's my last wave, and the thing just kept letting me go and go, and I was just going, gosh, this thing is going to put me to the shore break, and you know, the whole crowd's on the beach, and I just, you know, Mike Coe did it, I just thought about that, I had a lot of time to think about this, I was just going for a long time, and you know, I just had to do it.
Yeah.
After I won the Eddie, I just went, God, you know, everything has changed, and I knew I was gonna make it. I just had this feeling that, you know, everything has changed, and I just had this strong feeling, you know, I knew the waves were gonna be good, and I knew it just was meant to be that I was gonna make it. I broke my board and I didn't know it for like 5 minutes, and then I was like feeling my board. I'm like, oh my god,
like
my board.
That was
the heat with me, Parco, Shano, and Trent Monroe. And I put my leash on and I jumped in the water, but I got hooked on the fucking rock. And I was just like, fuck, what the fuck? This is everything. This is my turning point. What's gonna happen in my career? This can't be happening. This is not the way I'm gonna lose. Fuck, I was stressed out. Took the leash off and just bolted out there.
That I can't shake, with these dead birds, these feelings. And if there was a way, you know, I'd try to ride it straight out of here. But instead, I'm stuck with vampire and jungle beats that can't sleep through the trees. Talk about that.
Guy who's, you know, run the show here for the last, you know, 50 years. He's respected by everyone on the whole island, and you know, he's a gnarly waterman. He's a good surfer, a good guy, and you know, if anything wants to go on here, you have to ask him first. The Godfather.
He taught all of us who grew up on Kauai, me, Kalaa, Lion, my brother, everyone. You know, he taught us about, you know, respect, the ocean, the people, your elders, and he's a legend. You know, he paved the way from everybody in Kauai.
Bruce and Andy, I've known them when they were born, since they were little mutts, and you know, those two guys will always be going like this forever, you know, as long as they surf, as long as they're in the water. They were born to surf. True warriors for the surfing world. And I hope that both of them just keeps ripping the shit out of it.
So the boat trip coming up, your brother to go.
Yeah.
Why'd you pick him to go?
Because I think it'd be good to have him in the movie also, you know? Because he's a, you know, a big part of my life.
I can't believe it. They told me I was going on this boat trip. I was really surprised. I thought, like, it was a magazine trip and I had to go. I didn't know he actually picked me, so. for him to let me come on a trip with him with a bunch of my friends, I mean, it's gonna be insane. I'm looking forward to it in a big way.
Dude.
he'll punt it, he'll grab it, he'll judo kick it, he'll reverse it, he'll frontal, he'll backdoor it, whatever. He'll do it. With creepy fingers, too.
He just grew up at the beach, man. His whole life was surrounded by sand and water and bubbles.
I've known Bruce for quite some time now, and we've gotten to know each other pretty good. We're actually good friends now, so.
He's probably more mature than I am. He's got his act together. He's pretty down to earth, and it's all right.
He's taking his time, and Rome wasn't built in a day.
I think he's like the stealth bomber. He just comes in under the radar and then look out.
And then he kills.
Really.
I look up to those two guys now. I gotta go like this. Hey, how you doing, boy? And you know, it's like, hey, uncle, how you doing? Man, that's cool.
Maybe Mother Nature got some kind of deal going, and I'd like to know a little bit more about that.
I mean, he's got the biggest balls on you, he always had, but I mean, why am I? Oh, my goodness. This is like, whatever. He's like, whatever. That's just Bruce.
And he's just, he feeds on his friends around him, feeding him positive things.
If Bruce was the camera, what would you say to him? Look at the camera and say what you say to Bruce right now.
I don't know what to say to him. You're a kook. Nah.
Bone out, bone baby.
Nine.
Are we?
Yeah.
Boat nine.